Hail the tribe of the internet. I am Morty, and this is Chicken Police, the last episode. Well, if you watched the previous video, then you know that it's the second half of one long recording session. So it's gonna be a bit in medias res, you know, but please try to enjoy it anyway.
The city seems almost clean this time. Silent, mute, not of this world.
Good gods, you're really getting ready to die, aren't you?
I'm just messing with you, Marty. Relax.
Yeah, thanks. Very relaxing.
And how did we get this conversation? I was asking you something. I don't remember. It's fine. It's fine. I don't think you missed too much. We were just here talking about nothing. It's fine. It's fine. Louis almost became the third member of the team for all those times he got us out of trouble. How could I ever thank him? And what about what's her name? The Hummingbird girl. Monica. The Wessler residency. A fancy mansion somewhere at the end of the world. You just have to own one of you just have to own one if you are a billionaire gangster, right? Yes, yes. Okay, and I think we looked at everything. Yeah.
Did you forget anything, Sonny?
I don't know.
No, I just thought I'd take a look. Might be the last time I see it.
You becoming sentimental?
Who knows? Maybe I am.
Aw, that's cute.
Should I say it?
I know, Sonny. I can still get out.
But you won't.
On the beak.
Thanks, pal.
Forget about it. I'd be bored to death otherwise.
You know what? Okay, let's admit it. Marty grow on me a bit, okay? He is annoying and all, but yeah, he is a good friend, I think. I grown to like him. A bit, not too much. A bit. You want anything from here?
Abandon hope, all ye who enter here.
Very funny.
Funny, because it's true. You know, pulling the trigger was the toughest decision of my life.
You mean when you shot me?
Yeah.
Oh, but why have you done it? Would you mind telling me?
But it wasn't hard, because you thought you'd kill me.
Not at all, Sonny. I knew you'd survive. I wanted it to be a permanent injury and hurt like clucking hell. But I knew that everything would change from then on.
Okay, but why have you done it?
That something was gonna break between us?
Yeah, and that I was never gonna be the same either. With that shot, I also gunned down who I was, you know?
It really did hurt like hell.
But why have you done it? I want to know.
I know.
I almost bled to death.
Almost was the goal.
But why?
And did you manage to forgive me since then?
Well, what hurt me wasn't what you did. I mean, of course it did, but what hurt the most was you not trusting me. That you didn't believe me.
Not until you pulled the trigger. At that moment, I knew you were right. Ah, cluck.
But what happened? I need details. Come on, guys. Come on.
Yeah, cluck. All right, enough sentimental crap. We have an insane rat waiting to be put behind bars, and a woman you gotta get.
What?
Come on, Sonny. Even a blind bat can see it.
Oh, well. Cluck again.
Yeah, you see, I knew it.
Yep.
But what about Molly? Not the map. Sorry. I wanted to know. Damn, I'd be nowhere without you, partner, or most likely on the bottom of the river times. Yeah, but what about Molly? What?
Well, I don't even know what to think.
And it doesn't bother you that Natasha was also working at the brothel, was together with the gangster, and all of this But you are angry at Molly because, oh, she worked at the shady place. Oh no, how could she? You have a daughter from her. What the, what? I don't get it.
I wouldn't like to be in your place, Sonny. But this doesn't change the things that already happened, you know? Your memories remain the same.
Easy to say, Marty, but I feel like nothing's the same anymore. Even my fondest memories have been stolen from me.
Oh, but you still like Natasha.
You mean she stole them?
Yeah.
Maybe you should look for her. You know, you could find her. You've got the connections.
I could have done it already. Maybe I was too cowardly.
I don't even care. Okay, we can go, I think. You have anything else to tell me?
You didn't have the chance to tell me what happened to your brother.
You had a brother?
He left Clawville and I haven't talked to him since.
Oh, I'm sorry.
But I received an unexpected letter 2 weeks ago from the Su-Ra province. Someone dropped it off at my door.
Was it him?
He wrote the letter, that's for sure. I could smell the jungle when I opened it. But whether he was the one who delivered it, I don't know.
Have you tried to find him?
He'll find me if he wants to, Sonny. I know he's not guilty, and that's enough.
Oh, that's why you shot me?
But he's still wanted in Clawville, right?
Yeah.
Well, I'm sorry for playing a part in all of this.
Okay, okay.
I know, Sonny. The past is the past.
You know, you've truly changed, Marty. You try to hide it, but you've changed.
Thanks, boss.
Just, don't call me boss, okay? We're partners.
Oh, how sweet of you. Anything else?
I've also forgiven you, you know.
I don't remember asking for it.
I'm not mad anymore.
Blow me, Sonny. Do you always have to have the last word?
Of course not. I've also forgiven you.
Okay. Codex, what have we learned? Su-Ra province. Clawville has four colonies, the biggest and richest of them being the Su-Ra province, home to both a vast jungle and an even bigger savanna. Most of the exotic animals currently living in Clawville are from this province. Okay. So we wanted to arrest your brother for something he didn't commit, and then you shot us? Because, yeah, I get that. That's fine. That's a reasonable. I mean, it's not reasonable, but it's an acceptable reason, you know? Okay, so now we can go. Ooh! But we can go to other places as well. Do we want to? Mulan?
Well, if we have anything else to ask the old beaver, this is the last chance.
Hey, don't steal my style.
Just learning from the best.
Let me give you some advice. Don't.
Oh, and Seagull guy is not here anymore.
Oh, look what I found!
What have you found?
Furry gods. Another chicken police story.
And one of my favorites, too. Meredith outdid herself when she wrote this one.
Yeah, I can imagine.
You know, Sonny, you could read one day. They're not as bad as you think.
If it's about me and you, then I want none of it, thanks. Reality's more than enough.
Okay.
I can already see us on the next front page.
Yeah.
Or maybe in the obituaries.
Ah, you cranky, croaking old crow.
Okay.
And good old Mullen is still on duty.
Eternal, like the Knights of Clawville.
And the pain in my back.
What about the pain in your back, for real? Hi, can we ask? Oh, we can ask so many things. Oh my god.
Hey, old man. Sun's not even up yet. And you're already open?
You know what's my secret, Sonny boy?
You're not sleeping?
What?
I never close.
I thought so.
That clever.
How can I help you, lads? I see you're going somewhere.
Well, Sonny's going to die. I'm just wrapping up a delicate case.
So, you'll be off to the Wessler residency then?
You're sharp, old beaver.
Well, me dear lads, I'm glad I got to know you.
Hey, don't you start too.
That I'm just kidding.
Okay, let's talk.
Does the name Albert mean anything to you?
I know multiple Alberts, Sonny. Which one do you mean?
Albert Wessler.
I see you're in a funny mood, Sonny boy.
I'm not joking, Mullen, but I'm surprised there's something I know and you don't.
And who is this Albert, anyway? Ibn Wessler's hidden son, maybe?
Even better, my friend. His secret twin brother.
You've walked into trouble there.
I was hoping you could tell me something useful about him.
I can, Sonny boy. Avoid him. Avoid the whole Wessler family. Those who happen upon secrets that deep sink without a trace.
Well, I used to be a professional swimmer. Didn't you know?
No, I didn't.
I lied.
Death. Oh.
What do you know about that asylum? What's it called?
Since there's only one of those around Clawville, I know which one you mean, Sonny. It's an ancient mansion, easily around 100 years old for sure, or more. But what do you want to know about it anyway?
We actually just got out of there.
That explains everything.
Seriously, what do you know about it?
The place is self-sufficient in theory, but in reality, the Crown maintains it. No one knows the exact reason why, but according to gossip, they used to keep someone in there. Someone who was either part of the royal family or just very close to the fire. But who knows? Maybe it's just a legend?
Well, they say we're legends too, and we're standing right in front of you. Am I right?
What can I say then? This whole city is full of legends.
Interesting.
This Albert, he had to paint a picture of Natasha at his brother's request.
Let me guess. He fell in love with her.
Yeah, classic, huh? Then he killed his brother and took his place.
Yeah, well, that's a classic too. So, you're telling me who goes by Ibn Wessler is not really Ibn Wessler?
Exactly. He's Albert, a dangerous lunatic with multiple personality disorder.
Ha! Lads, I guess that Miss Marble's going to write another one of those novels about this.
You mean Meredith? Oh, that's just what we need.
Once you sold your soul, it's too late to cry about it, Sonny boy.
That's what I keep telling him.
The doctor?
Do you know Dr. Quetzal?
Do you mean Professor Quetzalcoatlus? Now you laugh at this, but we went to university together.
You did what?
Do I not look the type to you?
No, I didn't mean that. I just didn't know you went to university.
I studied psychology, Sonny. Only I forgot to graduate. That's when my father died.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So that's why you know the animals so well?
No, I know them well because I have a newspaper stand and I talk to hundreds of animals each day. And I listen to the everyday problems of almost all of them. There's no better lesson in animal studies.
You surprise me every time, old beaver. And what do you know about him? Can he be trusted?
You're afraid he screwed you. He looks like a terribly dishonest snake, but don't let your prejudices overshadow what your wattle tells you. Quetzal's one of the kindest-hearted and most honest animals I've ever known.
That's good to know, Uncle Mullen. Or rather, Professor Mullen.
Hey, don't get cocky with me, little chicky.
I just realized the snake's name, this Quetzal, I can't pronounce it, I'm sorry. But isn't it the name of a dinosaur? Like one of the flying dinosaurs? I'm going to look it up because I don't know, but it feels like it's a dinosaur name. The Wessler residence.
What do you know about the Wessler mansion, Uncle Mullen?
that if you're about to go there, bring a tank with you, or two.
Dangerous, you mean?
Dangerous? Ha! It's a fortress, so it is. Giant walls, watchtowers, and of course, Wesley's hired thugs are waiting for you there.
Yeah, sounds great.
It's a beautiful place, I must admit. At least you'll kick the bucket with mouths hanging open in wonder.
That's something.
Good attitude, my lad. Keep it.
Okay, thanks, I guess.
Got any good advice?
I always have some for you, lads. Don't get shot, for example.
Thanks.
That's very wise advice. Why haven't you told us before? Could have saved Sonny some painful memories.
If you carry on like that, Marty, you too can learn how it feels.
You too.
Okay, thank you, Mullen. I want to check in. Ooh, with Google. Hi. What up?
The old owl looks a bit tired.
Us too. I'm not sure I dare look in the mirror right now.
Don't do it, Marty. Sometimes I think about what a hot and popular gal Ursula used to be. Sometimes I... Hey, Bubo.
Pepe, you sleeping?
Hello, old man.
Is he asleep?
But his eyes are open.
Bubo!
Hey, what is it? I wasn't sleeping.
You were something.
What the hell are you doing here, chickens?
Sonny wanted to say hi before he suffers an unpleasant death of lead poisoning later tonight.
Would you shut the clock up, Marty? You're not funny.
I am a little bit.
You're going to Wessler's, huh?
Bingo. We're gonna put an end to this madness.
Ooh. Or you're stirring up an even bigger madness, am I right?
Well, that's always a possibility.
Get yourself killed for all I care, but don't come here covered in blood, because I'm not gonna open the door for you, I swear.
Unless you're sleeping and we can just walk right in.
Oh, thanks for the support, old fart.
Don't mention it, you old gizzard.
No hard feelings?
What can I say, boys? I have a big, soft heart.
You sure do, Ursula.
Would you like a nice hot cup of tea?
Yes, please. I would always like that.
No, thanks. We just came to say goodbye.
But I want a nice cup of tea. A nice hot cup of tea, please.
Why? You going somewhere? Traveling?
We're going to die.
No, we're just visiting a nice place in the city.
Sonny's gonna die.
Yes!
Shut up, Marty.
So it's a case. Well, be careful, boys. And I'm sorry I snapped at you the last time.
Nah, it's fine.
You don't need to say that, Ursula. We deserved it.
You're a good boy, Sonny. And Marty's a downright saint.
Oh, come on, Ursula. Stop that.
Can I give you a piece of advice, Martin?
Of course, Bubo. Go on.
Take care of the old rooster, okay?
Aww.
That's all I ever do, Doc.
Can I give you a piece?
Okay. How is the old owl?
He's old and grumpy, but he's always like that.
Wait a minute. Isn't he supposed to sleep now?
He is. I mean, Reginald's never truly asleep. Not entirely. He just shuts down.
He's meditating.
Even now?
Yes.
I gotta see that.
Yeah, we saw that.
Take care of yourselves, boys.
Will do, Auntie Ursula.
Hey, don't be saucy, young man.
Oh. It seems Ursula found her way back to Bubble. What can I say? Love is a murderous bee. All is right in the world again. Ursula is back and Bubble is still a grumpy, insufferable old owl. The balance of the universe is restored. Okay, hi guys, we are going to die. Okay, where to next? Hot Dog, Moon's Reverter, the Atlas Reverter, the Weekend House, and the Hot Dog. What can we do at the Hot Dog?
You know, Sonny, few places are as cozy as the Hot Dog at dawn.
You have a point.
The silence, the fog, the sunshine slowly devouring the sleeping city.
The smell.
Yeah. The Cobbler District has its own distinctive aroma, that's for sure. But wait, do you smell that?
Coffee? Pancake? Which one?
It seems Zip is ready with the first batch of coffee.
They let him out so soon?
That's waiting only for us, my friend.
The Fly Guy! Fly Guy is not here! Where are you, Fly Guy? Where are you? Oh, I wanted to say goodbye to you too. Oh.
Well, he's out. He's brave indeed. Or an idiot.
They're often the same, Marty. And you should know.
Wait a minute. The sun is being ripped off.
Old Zip's finally come to his senses.
I think we may have got to him.
Aww.
We get to everybody, Boss Bird. Everybody.
Or he just felt guilty, you know, because of dropping off with that body at the hive. So, yeah. And we finally... Oh, hi, yeah. We trashed it. Yeah, sorry. But it still works, it seems like, so...
Hey, Zip. Listen here. This coffee, it's 2 days old.
And...
nothing.
Not the menu, I don't care. Hi, Zip.
Let's say hi to the old trash panda.
You mean a last goodbye, right?
Yeah. Hi.
Hello, Zip. I see they kicked you out.
You know, Sonny, they told me I could stay in there for 48 hours if I wanted.
Well, maybe you should have done that.
Shit, I had enough. Fuck it, you understand? When you interrogated me, you opened my eyes. I don't give a shit about him, about Wesler and his henchmen. Let them come if they want. It's not gonna be easy for them, you can be sure of that.
That's the Zip we know and love.
Thanks, Marty. So, why are you here?
One last coffee before the end.
Are you going to get him?
We don't have a choice, Zip. We're grabbing the rat by the tail. No screwing around. No playing it nice.
I see Ibn's really got to you.
Just Sonny. I'm like this all the time.
Yeah, that's true.
Aww.
And what do you expect will happen when you get there?
They'll either let us in, or we'll blow open the doors and go in guns blazing. How hard can it be?
Well, I'm not sure you know what you're up against, boys, but... It's your funeral. I'm just glad I got to know the legendary chicken police.
Hey, don't write us off yet.
I'm just getting ready for all possibilities, Marty. Hey, chicken coppers.
Yeah?
Yeah, Zip?
Take care of your feathers for me, okay?
Oh, thank you.
Will do, Zip.
Don't worry. I'll protect this smelly old bird.
All in all, thanks, Zip. You've been a great help.
Thank you too, boys. You really opened my eyes. If I see Wesler again or any of his goons, I'm gonna plug him right there.
I'm not sure you're supposed to, you know, go for them, but I'm happy for you, I guess.
I'm not sure that's what we're suggesting.
One more coffee, boys?
Yes, please.
Thanks, Zip. Maybe next time.
Oh, but why? No tea for me, no coffee for me. Why are you like this?
If there is a next time.
one more coffee, boys?
Okay. Bye-bye, Zip. I'm gonna be back and then we can have coffee together. Wait for me, Bebe. Bye-bye. Then we only have, so we were at Mullins, we were at the hotel at Bubbles, and we are at the Hop Dog right now. So the Weekend House is our last stop.
We're looking for more evidence?
No, I was just thinking we could take another look, you know, just in case.
Okay, sure, but...
Don't even ask, Marty.
You're really becoming sentimental.
One more word and I swear I'm...
Yep, I'm gonna shut it.
Oh, they took the shoe! Wait, we never figured out whose shoe was that. Whose shoe was it?
Well, they couldn't even manage to scrape it off.
They didn't even want it to, I think.
Useless pincushions.
They're always half-assed, Sonny. You drive me crazy.
Leave them be. Your record is perfect. You've been on the force for 15 years, almost 10 of that with me.
That's why I deserve a medal.
Get out, wind down, resign, become, let's see, anything.
Yeah, if you only knew how much I've thought about that. But I'm simply not good at anything else. Either I'm a gangster or a cop. I've got too much of a backbone to be a gangster.
Also to be a cop, Marty.
Aw, oh, that was mean.
You don't want to go in there just like that. It's a closed crime scene.
I hope you're just messing with me, Marty.
Of course I'm messing with you. Let's get inside there and see how much the boys have messed up the place. You know, Sonny, when we entered the room and saw the girl...
Deborah.
Yeah, her body. I called you every name in the book inside my head. I just had enough, you know? I wanted to quit.
But you stayed.
What kept you with me? Was it just curiosity?
No. I just wanted to see your downfall, boss. I wanted to be there when you met your end, get humiliated or even shot.
Thanks, I guess.
Wow. Well, thanks for your honesty, Marty.
But then everything changed on the ship.
On the ship? Why there?
I don't know. Being tied up with you, waiting for certain death. I know I lashed out at you, but in truth, I felt there was no place I'd rather be. It was my place on that fucking burning ship with you, even if we both died there. Know what I mean?
Not really, but thank you anyway.
I think I do, Marty. I think I do.
Aww.
So, I guess there's nowhere to go but forward, huh?
Nothing left to do but kill a rat. As the chicken police.
For the last time?
For the last clucking time, partner.
No, we know that's not true.
Swear?
Nuh-uh.
I swear.
Nuh-uh.
All right. Let's hit the road.
Just like that? I can't even look at anything? Okay, oh. We can look only at the family photo and the painting. Oh, and the stuff. And I want to look at this.
Natasha became even more mysterious with every detail we learned about her.
You fell for her hard, huh?
It's nothing like that, Marty. I only met her one time. It just makes me crazy if I can't solve something. And she's something I just can't solve.
Maybe you have to accept this one, Boss Bird. That woman's out of your league. From a different world entirely.
Eh, you're probably right.
Nice.
Yeah, it really is.
You think Albert painted it as well?
Human, huh? My partner loves these weird things.
Your who?
I got a new partner when you left.
When Blood Boil fired me?
Sure, when you were fired. His name is Melvin, a little greenhorn of an otter.
And where exactly is he?
I have no idea. We worked together for one day. Then I told everyone I wasn't gonna work with anyone but you.
Aw, you're so sweet.
But you hated me.
Yeah. I was even a little afraid they'd call you back. But Bloodboil got it. So he let me work alone.
That feels strangely comforting.
Oh, you are so sweet. It seems Marty was only playing stupid for a long time to see how the mighty Santino Featherland falls down. To be honest, I understand him, and I think I deserve it. Yeah. So now we can go to the Wessler Residency.
The sun was shining, and all the ducks were in a row. I felt ready. The pieces of the grand puzzle were laid out on the table. I just needed to piece them all together. A revealing glance or a careless word, and I'd have the answer. I knew we were in the right place. I knew it was nearly over. Was Natasha really just a victim? Or did she know everything? Was she controlling the puppets from behind the curtain? Well, if you don't know where to go, go straight ahead. What could possibly go wrong? Here I am, Natasha. I hope you're waiting for me.
Furry gods! I knew he was rich, but wow!
Half the city is in his hands, Marty. And half the Council of 12.
But there are colors here! Can you see? And we are still black and white. Why are there colors here?
I think we'll catch a big fish today.
Don't count your chickens. I'm sure Wessler's expecting us. And Natasha too, I hope.
You hope?
If I'm right, she could be our only chance of survival.
Lovely prospects, huh?
I've had worse.
Really?
Look at the colors! I mean, they only have green, right? Yeah, they only have green, and Natasha's eyes are green as well. So what about the green? Oh no, they have red as well. What?
Oh, this place has its own greenhouse. What do you think's inside?
100% humidity and unbearable heat.
Oh, not like that. Could they be growing rarities in there?
Or maybe some chicken-eating giant flower monsters.
What? Oh, you just made that up, right? Nah, I'm sure there's no such thing.
Red knight?
Huh, one of Wessler's ancestors, maybe.
Wessler's ancestors were poor cobblers. More likely, this represents what he thinks of himself.
I wonder how chivalry is compatible with organized crime.
Ibn was planning to leave the underworld.
When his twin brother tore out his tongue, poked out his eye, killed him, and took his place?
Yes!
Yeah.
Aww. Okay.
What the hell is it? Water tower? Turret? A frickin' lighthouse?
I think it's a monument to an enormous ego, Marty.
Well, anyone who builds a tower this big must be trying to compensate for something.
Or he just has too much dough.
Quite the steed, isn't it?
Seems nowadays organized crime pays well in Clawville.
Are you surprised? The chicken police retired.
Well, they say the team's back together again.
Nah, that's impossible.
Oh yeah, it's true.
Is this a mansion? or a grand palace.
Or a small city.
Well, if it comes to hide and seek, Old Westlair will have an advantage.
A serious advantage.
Hey, not so fast, chickens.
Hi there. Hi.
Please excuse my partner. He didn't mean to be rude. It's just his terrible habits, as you may already know.
That's why you tried to shoot us twice.
Look who's here.
What a surprise. Our biggest fans.
What do you think? Should we give them our autographs?
Ah, look what the cat dragged in.
Funny, I don't recognize them.
Well, maybe if they had some guns with them? Tommy guns?
Oh yeah, now I remember. The two suckers in the luxury van you shot to pieces. Twice.
Exactly.
Oh, what are you doing here, chickens? Would you like us to finish what we started?
We'd love to have fun with you boys, but we need to talk to your boss. And while we're at it, the lady of the house is also expecting us.
Is that so?
Yeah, that's so horny.
In that case, I guess there's no reason for us to waste your precious time. Isn't that right, Gabriel? Get the hell out of our sights while there are still feathers on your skin, chickens.
Are you just gonna let us through? Just like this?
Easy, pal. We're not even here anymore. Until next time, boys.
Really? Just like that we can go?
Do you sense that, Sonny?
I do sense something. A case of hyper-stupidity.
And utter incompetence.
You're right.
Don't shit with me, you fowl! It won't work well for you. I'm afraid my partner speaks the truth, gentlemen.
Such tall and handsome creatures, aren't they, partner?
Sure are, partner. Do you sense that, Sonny?
I do.
Okay, that's the same, and we can only go in.
This must lead to Westler and Natasha's suite.
Well, let's get the big guns out and kick the door down.
No need for that, Marty. We'll wait until they invite us in, like real gentlemen. Then maybe we'll need the guns. But I hope it won't come to that.
Oh, my trigger finger's itching, Sonny. Someone's gotta pay.
Relax, Marty. Someone is gonna pay.
Yeah. Just don't let it be us.
They have all these fancy colors! Like all the... What do you call it? This brownie orange thing, and the green, and oh, it's so pretty! How are you collecting the colors?
This place is incredible, but it kinda gives me the creeps.
Because you know what lies behind the beauty.
With Natasha, too?
I haven't decided yet.
It's like the vegetation's trying to suffocate these beautiful walls.
Maybe it will. Maybe in 100 years, nothing will be here but plants. An endless, planet-sized jungle.
That's quite a dark thought.
Yeah, it is.
It's not a dark, it's a bit romantic, isn't it? Oh, stairs, we can just leave.
I wasn't expecting to see Olivia here.
Why though? Why? She's Eben's personal.
She's real close to Westler. But how much does she know?
Much more than me, I guess.
That wouldn't be hard.
Ah, what a pleasant surprise. Hello, Olivia. Sweetie.
Get lost.
What did you say, ma'am?
Turn around and get the hell out of here now, if you want to make it out with feathers intact.
Come on, Olivia. Don't worry about us. We know what we're doing.
Mutton!
Huh?
Don't you get it? You have to get out of here or you'll be in danger, and also her.
Do you mean Natasha? Please calm down, miss. We have to talk to Mr. Westler and Miss Katsenko.
You really don't understand, do you?
Oh.
What do they not understand, Olivia?
Hi, pretty.
So, what is it exactly that our guests don't understand?
Oh, I love it. I don't know what is it. It's like I don't know. I don't know what this is. It's part of your pajamas? I don't know, but I like it.
I was trying to tell the detectives that Mr. Westler's very tired and doesn't welcome guests this early. He gets rather irate if he's being disturbed at this hour.
I'm sure Mr. Featherland and Mr. McChicken can wait here while Ibn refreshes himself. I'll entertain them until then.
Thank you, Miss Pitsenko.
Please, Sonny, I thought we've already discussed this. Call me Natasha.
Please, Natasha, can we talk to you in private?
Martin? It's all right, Olivia. These gentlemen are my friends.
Yes, Miss Katsinko.
Oh, hi.
You know, I had a dream before we came here. I saw Natasha with a bloody mouth and red claws.
Oh yeah, we did. We did. I almost forgot.
And? What does that tell you?
I don't know, Marty. I admit it. I haven't been this on edge for a long time.
I'm just angry. Truth is, I'm not entirely sure why.
Your sense of justice kicking in?
More like my sense of don't fuck with the chicken police. There she is, the femme fatale.
Yeah, our fate's in her hands.
And what lovely hands they are, huh?
With sharp claws, Marty.
The truth is, Ibn isn't really in a good shape today, gentlemen. He's rather furious. Are you sure this can't wait?
You commissioned us, Natasha, and we barely escaped with our combs intact.
So you know who left the threats?
Oh, we know much more than that, Natasha. We even know where you used to work. We talked to Madame Zavas.
Wild gods!
Why didn't you tell us?
Do you think it's easy for a woman to talk about such things, that she used to be an escort?
Along with Molly?
So you know.
Yeah, I know, Natasha. I also know all of this was a trap.
Believe me, I tried to handle things the least painfully I could. You weren't even supposed to know.
A lot shouldn't have happened. Poor Deborah shouldn't have had to die.
Dear sweet Deborah.
Cold, stiff Deborah.
Please don't say that.
A price worth paying?
You cannot think I had anything to do with that. You just cannot.
I don't know, Natasha.
Please, Sonny, tell me, what is going on?
You have to know, right?
Please.
Excuse me for making you wait, detectives. I'm having a rough morning after a long night.
Is that so? Our night was also kinda long.
To put it mildly.
I was just telling the gentlemen that you were exhausted, my dear, and they should come back another time. I'll escort them out.
Oh, honey, no need for that. My door's always open to the legendary chicken police. Please, come on in, guys. Let's talk in my room.
Then this way, please.
You just stay here, my darling. I'm sure our conversation will bore you to death. Please, go and refresh yourself, or tell Olivia to go make some coffee.
Yes, dear. Whatever you like.
Please, follow me, gents.
Lead on, Westler. So long, sweetheart.
Goodbye.
Olivia. Olivia tried to shoo us out of the Westler Mansion. Strange, but she seemed quite worried about our lives. And the other? Albert. What? What? What have we learned? What have we learned? Let's see, what have we learned about you? I don't know. Natasha? Natasha tried to send us away from the Westler estate, but why? Was she worried about us, or did she have a different motive? We can't talk to you anymore.
Come
we
on,
can only
Sunny.
Look.
Deep breath. Pull yourself together.
Okay, so we just go upstairs now. Hi. Can I look around your room? A book! Farewell from Fowl! Yay! Thank you! Oh, another painting! Or the painting! Oh, it is an other painting! Oh, and there is the corner missing! Oh, I thought the painting that we talked about was the one in Natasha's room in the Tsar Club, but no, it was this one. It's a pretty one, I like it very much.
This painting,
it's beautiful and rather provocative, almost makes my comb stand up.
I'm not surprised.
But the corner is missing.
You're right, Sonny. You're quite the observer.
Well, yeah, this painting's unfortunately damaged. I don't know where the missing piece could be.
You don't know? Well, if you're interested, we know exactly where it is.
Oh, I messed it up again.
Really?
Really. It's here with us.
I didn't want it to progress it.
An insignificant little piece, isn't it? But there's an exciting cat scratch on it.
More like a rat scratch, because it's a monogram.
A.W.
That's...
Albert Westler. He's a great painter. I don't know if you've heard of him.
Enough! Out with it already. What are you trying to say? I have no time for your childish charades.
Easy, Westler. We'll get to that in a bit.
Okay, thank you. Night table? Ooh, okay.
Would you like a drink? This is a rather rare brandy. It lifts the spirits, if I may be so, poetic.
Really? Tempting, but I need to keep a clear head, Mr. Westler.
I've heard you don't despise a good vintage.
And I've heard you don't despise murder, Westler. By the way, you've heard right. But everything has its place and time. Drinks, guns, dead bodies, and the truth.
I see you're in a poetic mood as well.
More like prophetic.
And that's not a good sign.
Yeah. Are you trying to intimidate me?
No, that's not how we do business. We're gentlemen.
I really hope so.
Do you keep a revolver in your bedroom?
A bad habit. One who has a lot to lose has a lot to fear.
I agree.
Okay. Pricey bed. Yeah, and it looks very comfy.
Impressive bed. Looks cozy.
Yeah, right.
Sure is better than a cell.
That's right, Marty.
I'm not sure I understand, gentlemen.
We'll see about that. This estate is rather impressive, Mr. Westler.
Well, thank you.
I suppose it took years and years of cumbersome work to build it.
Yeah. As you say, Mr. Featherland, I'm rather proud of it.
You should be. Whoever built this place has a reason to be proud of himself.
Are you trying to say something, sir?
No, just thinking aloud.
I think there is nothing more that we can look at. Alright, hi!
Interesting. Now that I know who he really is, he doesn't even resemble Ibn Westler. The whole thing is so transparent. We must finally put an end to this case, even if it kills us.
Okay, I understand.
So, what do you want to know? I've heard you've been through a rather eventful few days.
Oh, you have rather good informants.
Few days? I thought it was just a night and half a day.
Yeah, that's true. I should tell you, I see and hear everything that happens in the city. And you are exceptionally resilient. No offense.
None taken. But tell me, are we gonna flatter each other for a long time, or are we finally done with the courting?
Straight to the point. I like it. Yeah, so let's continue like that, shall we? What do you want? How dare you intrude upon me in my own house?
Oh, forgive us. Our moral compass has been confused a little bit after someone tried to kill us several times in the last 48 hours. With fire, with machine guns. I could go on.
And while we're at it, you could answer some of our questions. If you've nothing to hide, you have nothing to fear.
And then we'll just leave you alone.
All right. I'll go along with your childish little game. I would have had a long and tedious day ahead of me anyway. So, can we start?
With pleasure, Mr. Wessler.
My time's precious, chickens. Get to the point before I lose my patience.
Don't rush us, Mr. Wessler. We'll get to the point.
Okay, I understood. Natasha?
I have no idea what she sees in you, but Natasha's been seriously worried about you.
Yeah, she, really worries more than usual, but it's understandable. Those disgusting messages.
Disgusting, all right. Do you know why that word exactly? Why did they write that specific word everywhere?
Since you've been to the Nile, I guess you know the answer to your question.
Didn't it bother you, Wessler, what Natasha used to do? Surely it must have upset you.
Why? Did it upset you when you discovered your wife did the same thing?
What did you just say?
What did you think, chicken? That I didn't know? Yeah, don't make me laugh. I know about everyone who ever set foot in that place. I can even tell you who Molly's regulars were, if you're interested.
You son of a bitch.
Sonny, don't.
Yes, detective?
Not yet.
You're right, Marty. It's not worth it.
You're funny, you know that?
About the painting.
Yeah. My brother Albert made it. He's a great talent, but, he's a rather troubled individual.
Such self-criticism.
What did you say?
My partner means that you and your brother are very much alike. Identical twins, if I'm not mistaken.
Indeed. But, what does that have to do with the painting?
We'll get to that. Don't worry, Mr. Wessler. So Albert made the painting at your request, is that right? And the one that's in Natasha's room in the Tsar, too.
Oh, so he made both.
Yeah, exactly. Is that a crime?
No, it's not a crime in itself. This picture, it's rather strange, you know?
Why do you think so? It's just me, Natasha, and my brother.
The photo doesn't tell much in itself, yes. But if you already have the right information, suddenly it starts to talk.
Really?
He fell in love with her, didn't he?
Who do you mean?
Albert, of course. He fell in love with Natasha. All those sessions while he was painting the pictures. Were you there every time?
You mean, me?
You.
No, I mean... While Albert was painting, yeah, but I wasn't there all the time. Albert was there, all along.
And you think he could have fallen in love with Natasha? That's why he escaped? What do you think happened to him? Who tore out his tongue?
I have no idea.
Did Natasha know about what happened to your brother?
No, of course not.
Do you love beautiful things, Wessler?
Why do you ask that? Yeah, of course.
You were afraid of losing her, weren't you? To him.
Stop. Enough. If you want to ask something, ask clearly. Don't play with me. You understand?
We're just doing our job.
Then do it clearly and quickly. Yeah, I'm really starting to lose my patience.
We visited Albert's cell and found something he seems to have forgotten to take with him in his great hurry.
That's a big mistake.
A classic, even.
What the hell are you babbling about?
This is Albert Wessler's love letter to Natasha.
More like a confession.
In which he tells her he's capable of doing anything for her, even the most horrible things.
Yeah, this letter doesn't prove anything at all. Albert is mad. Insane. He's not a normal. No one would believe his word, don't you understand?
But they believe yours, right? Because you're not Albert Wessler. You're Hobart Ibn Wessler, aren't you? How good it feels to be in his skin.
How dare you?
Just tell him, Sonny. I'm getting tired of this.
You're just a cheap fake, Albert. You couldn't follow in your brother's footsteps even if you wanted to. No matter how hard you tried, you couldn't get Natasha either. Am I right?
What? What did you just say?
She hates you, doesn't she? She doesn't know. She doesn't understand why. But she hates you. It's instinctive.
Yeah, what do you know? What could you possibly know about suffering and loneliness and the darkness? What could you know about hate, huh?
We don't have anything to read.
My time's precious, chickens. Get to the point before I lose my patience.
Don't rush us, Mr. Wessler. We'll get to the point when it's time.
Okay, then let's do this. Well, this escalated quickly. Can I shoot
you? Albert is an imposter. He's not who he says he is, and might not even know who he really is. I have to concentrate on this first to soften him up. And to avoid us being shot in the gizzard, of course.
Why don't just shoot him? I want to shoot him! Okay, when did you pick that up that was on your nightstand? Okay, imposter, I know that. What do we have to use? Oh yeah, he don't know who he really is, okay. What were you thinking, Albert? How long did you think you could keep it up?
What were you thinking, Albert? How long did you think you could keep it up?
Until the end of my life, if needs. Yeah, I cared about nothing except for her to love me. Not for who Ibn was, but for who I am.
Why did you think that would happen? Everybody noticed the change.
Yeah, I knew it would be hard, Santino. But I also knew animals see what they want to see. Yeah, I didn't have to behave like Ibn. They only had to believe I'm him.
Okay. Manipulator, yeah. You wanted to wrap everyone around your dirty little fingers. Why did you decide to take your brother's place? I mean, we know that, right? But we don't want to get shot either.
Why did you decide to take your brother's place?
Yeah, as you're curious. From the moment I laid eyes on Natasha for the first time. But I had to convince myself that this was the only way.
You've never talked about your feelings for Natasha with your brother, am I right?
Are you insane? Yeah, Ibn would have had me killed immediately. And no one would ever know.
So instead, you've done the same thing, haven't you? What a comfortable excuse.
Comfortable? Do you think all of this was just some kind of cruel game for me? I had to destroy the person I loved and respected the most.
Cry me a river.
You know, there's only a thin, fragile membrane between love and hate. If anything touches it, it tears immediately. You've felt like this before, haven't you? I can see it in your eyes.
With Molly,
You can analyze me until the sun goes down, Wessler. But you won't get far with that.
Yeah, evasive answer. so I'm right.
Okay, that's a big plus. Cruel. Did you ever believe that you were Iban? You wanted to rep... Yeah. Why did you have to mutilate Iban? Why didn't you just kill him immediately? Did you ever believe that you were him? Or why did you have to... Why didn't you just kill him immediately? He's cruel. But he don't know who he really is. I'm afraid this is gonna be a big minus, but...
Why did you have to mutilate Iban? Why didn't you just kill him immediately?
That's an interesting question, you see, but the answer is exceptionally simple. No matter how strange it is for you to understand, I loved my brother.
Weird way of showing your love, Albert.
You can't understand that. He was my everything, the only one who was close to me. Until I met Natasha.
But you weren't close to her at all.
She took your brother's place pretty quickly, didn't she? There's not much room in your heart, as I see it.
Yeah, you're understanding the situation, Detective, but you know, very well it's not that simple. Iban was my brother. I loved him despite all of his flaws and foul, petty lies. That's why I couldn't kill him.
Not immediately, you mean?
Unfortunately, tearing out his tongue wasn't enough. Yeah, I must admit I've, underestimated him.
And poking out his eye?
Oh, that was just an accident, Mr. Featherland.
Just an accident? You're a dirty, clucking son of a vermin, Albert.
Please, don't be vulgar, Sonny. It's too dangerous in your current situation, and doesn't even suit you.
Yeah, that was a minus, I thought so, but not as big as I thought it was gonna be. So you feel you are two people at the same time even now. Did you enjoy tearing out? No. Does it make you happy to control others? Nay, you feel you're two people?
So you feel you're two people at the same time, even now.
Does it sound crazy? Maybe it is. But Iban lives inside me. Sometimes he's even stronger than Albert ever was.
Do you think you can avoid the gas chamber with this, Albert?
I don't have to avoid anything, Sonny. You and your friend, will never leave this place. It's better if you start getting used to the thought.
You're not the cold-blooded killer you'd like to think you are.
Yeah, do you think so? Try me, Detective.
Okay, we came back. What would you have done if Natasha found out? Kill her too? That was your plan, take his place and live happily ever after? What made you think you can deceive Natasha? I mean... Kill her too? He seems to be sensitive about these things. That was your plan, take his place and live happily ever after?
Take his place and live happily ever after.
Why? Isn't it good enough of a plan, Mr. Featherland? Oh, it was perfect. Even
he's shaking
in its imperfection.
As well.
Which is?
Iban's ghost.
What?
His what?
Please don't take it literally, Mr. Chicken. I'm not talking about spirits. When Iban died, I didn't just take his place, but also his role. He himself, his essence, if you will. Yeah, though I guess that's too much for you to understand.
So you mean Iban's here with us even now?
He was here all along. Don't you get it? I am Hobart Iban Wessler.
Yeah, you have a few screws. Yeah.
I must get serious, because looking at the gun in Wessler's trembling hand, I'm afraid I don't have much time. Albert is a cruel psychopath, but maybe I can turn that cruelty against him.
Okay. Oh, plus 20, thank you. When was the moment you decided to kill him, Albert?
When was the moment you decided to kill him, Albert?
When I drew the last stroke on that fatal painting, Mr. Featherland. When I glanced at it for the last time, and then at Natasha, who was shivering under the weight of my gaze.
You simply fell in love with her? End of story?
Not in the slightest, Mr. Featherland. Love is, just chemistry. What I felt was more than that.
Everybody thinks that, Albert. But we all feel the same. We're just fools.
No, Mr. Featherland. Not at all. At that moment, I knew what I was gonna do. I knew that the world was coming to an end if I didn't do it. It implodes on itself and ceases to exist. I couldn't let that happen. I couldn't.
Let him have her, right? You simply wanted her for yourself.
I wanted her for ourselves, Sonny. I was him by then. He just didn't know it yet.
Sure, yeah, sure. Okay. You're just a cheap copy, you know that, right? Do you think you can explain everything with your insanity? What did you do that made even get you locked up? Oh yeah, what did you do? You enjoyed leading everyone by the nose, didn't you? Wounded. What did you do that made even get you locked up? I'm interested.
What did you do that made Ibn get you locked up?
That's a sharp turn, detective.
I know, but I'm interested.
It just came to me, you know? Where did it all start? Where did all the hate and jealousy come from?
Jealousy? What are you talking about?
Aw, come on, Albert. Alone. Locked up at the end of the world, while your brother is one of the most influential figures of Clawville, driving an expensive car, living in a mansion, with the city's most desirable woman in his bed. Why wouldn't you be jealous?
Yeah, Albert was jealous of Ibn. Maybe he still is. But I understand why he did it. Albert was beyond control and dangerous.
What does that mean exactly?
Albert did our mother wrong. Poor old mom. She never heard a fly. But Albert couldn't take that she was praising his brother all the time while Albert was just an unsuccessful, foolish, poor painter.
Oh, but he's a very good painter.
What did you do to her, Albert?
Albert killed her. It looked like an accident, but Ibn knew it wasn't. That was the last straw. Albert had to be locked up, and he agreed. He never said no to his brother.
But he never forgot who did this to him either, did he?
Ibn was really good to him. Visited him every week. Did everything he could. Even introduced Natasha in the end.
And that was his downfall.
Both of them, Sonny. And yours, too.
Okay, it was a tiny plus. Tiny plus is still a plus. Did you hate Ibn or yourself more? When did you decide that we two have to die? I mean, neither of these seem to be the way I would want to take this. Did you hate Ibn or yourself more? When did you decide that we two have to die? I mean, this is a stupid question, isn't it? Like, at the very beginning, when we met at the club, didn't we?
Did you hate Ibn or yourself more, Albert?
Albert hated himself the most ever since he was born.
He
idolized Ibn. But every time his brother stood before him, he saw what he could have been himself if he had enough strength. But he didn't. Albert had always been a coward, a pitiful nobody.
And now?
Finally, there's no more Albert. And no more Ibn either. It's only me, and for both of them, I'm perfect.
Oh, I'm sorry. You've been through a lot, and I understand that, but still, it's not the way to go.
Can it be that the fear is making you say these things, Albert?
Stop calling me that.
I have to call you something. What should I call you? What name should I use?
I don't know anymore. I don't.
I'm very close to breaking him. But if I'm too hard on him, I could quickly be signing my death warrant. It's time to dig a little bit deeper and uncover Wessler's wounds.
-5. What? Okay. Natasha was kind to you, right? Too kind. If you still had a spine, you would put that gun to your own head. What? No! Natasha was kind to you.
Natasha was kind to you, right? Too kind.
Natasha was a simply amazing, gentle, kind, lively, but still so distant.
You're telling me.
It's like she was from another world. A world where everything's full of charm and grace, and everything's fragile and delicate. Do you understand?
I think I do, yes.
I knew Albert's touch would harm her. Albert is rough. Albert can't keep such a delicate thing in his arms.
That's why you had to become Ibn, am I right?
I didn't take Ibn's place, Mr. Featherland. I became one with him, can't you see? It's the only way I could comprehend and accept the miracle that was Natasha.
Was.
I think I've corrupted her. She's not that gentle and pure creature I painted on the canvas anymore. I ruined her. She became rotten under my hands.
Wow. Well, you know, that's called reality. Oh, big plus. Maybe it's not too late, Albert. Tell her the truth and end this.
Maybe it's not too late, Albert. Tell her the truth and end this.
No! You can't understand this. She can't either. I killed Ibn, but he also killed me, can't you see? We're nothing without each other.
You can't be two people at the same time, Albert. Nobody can bear the weight of the sins of two souls.
Ibn loved her. I admired her. Ibn was crazy about her. I've been crazy for a long time. Ibn idolized her, and I hated her. And if there's anything more blind, more devoted, more extreme, and more true than love, it could only be hate, Mr. Featherland. It's an endlessly exciting, thrilling, and warm feeling, and infinitely red. Just like love.
Sure, yeah,
You know you're not going to be able to go through with it, right? That you won't be able to carry the weight. But you still did it. Why?
Yeah, if I didn't kill him and become one with him, Albert would have died, Mr. Featherland.
And the threats? Which one of you was that? Albert or Ibn? Who wrote them? And which one of you killed Deborah?
In my world, Ibn and I are inseparable. Just like love and hate are one and the same. And I hate Natasha so much that I could destroy myself along with her, just so she would die with me. Are you familiar with this feeling, Mr. Featherland?
I mean, what? I mean, yeah. Okay. I understand what you are trying to say here, but, why haven't you? Why haven't you killed her already? If we are at it.
More than life itself.
You see? We're not so different after all.
You and I have nothing in common, Wessler. You know why?
Why, Mr. Featherland?
Because if I were in your shoes, I would have pulled the trigger a long time ago.
Goodbye, Sonny.
So long, Albert.
Can we shoot him already? Questioning 60%, only 4 stars. But we can't have that. We can't have that. It would be our only 4 stars. We can't have that.
Albert is an imposter. What were you thinking? Why did you decide? Did you ever believe? So you feel...
Hey? Or after... I don't remember if it's a plus or minus.
That was your plan. I must get...
It's a big plus?
When was the moment you...
Big plus? Cheap copy, no. Did you look you up? No. You think you're gonna explain everything?
Do you think you can explain everything with your...
Don't be a fool, Sonny. Insanity is just a temporary state. just a stop on the way to enlightenment.
So you admit you're insane? That's surprising for your kind.
Of course I'm not insane.
Ah, well, here we are.
Albert was insane. He lost all connections to reality. But I saved him.
You mean you're Ibn?
Both of us, Mr. Featherland.
Okay. I almost understand everything now.
Don't mock me, Mr. Featherland. You're still at the wrong end of the gun, you remember?
It would be hard to forget.
Okay, to the big plus.
Did you hate Ibn? I'm very close.
It wasn't my lie!
Natasha was...
Big plus?
Maybe it's not too...
Please just give it to me. Thank you! Thank you! Thank you! Thank you! Thank you! Albert is Ibn Wessler himself. The madman took his brother's place and is trying to tie up loose ends. If we don't catch him now, maybe it will be too late. Oh my god. Oh hi. Don't shoot, please. I'm not ready to shoot back. Yeah? What up? Marty? Oh, hi, lady. Were you listening in?
So, you heard everything.
I heard everything.
I'm sorry you had to find out like this.
And thank you. If it weren't for you...
Well, what about you and your big gun?
Yes, both of you would be dead, I know. But believe me, I still thought carefully before firing.
About who to target?
You know, I truly loved Ibn.
But this man wasn't him. You felt it, didn't you?
Maybe I even knew it. I don't know. But I still can't believe it.
It won't be easy to process for any of us.
I'm sorry I dragged you into this. And regarding Molly?
The cops? But how? How do they know?
I have no idea, Marty.
Do not look at me. I did not call them.
Olivia?
Don't worry, Natasha. They won't lay a finger on you. I promise.
Please, Sonny. You don't need to worry about me.
I don't want to be rude, Sonny, but I'm more worried about us than her. Hello, boss.
Hi.
Hello, boys.
Before you say anything, we can explain.
No need for that, Santino. Monica already told me everything.
What?
Monica?
What we trusted you?
Hey, boys. What were you thinking? That I would just let you get killed without saying goodbye?
Oh, yeah. We haven't talked to you. That's right.
Thanks, Mon. Should we say we owe you one?
You know already, boys. Shoes are my weakness.
Yeah, wait. For 45 black high heels, right? Right, am I right?
Hey, mine too.
Of all that's furry, we don't want to hear that. And boys...
Yes, boss?
Don't believe you'll get away with it so easily. I want a report on my desk from both of you with all the details. Am I clear?
But I'm not even a cop.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. It'll all make sense, believe us. Right after I figure out myself what the hell just happened.
What Marty's trying to tell you is that we had good reason to investigate outside the law. But we're sorry.
What happened to you, Sonny? You're sorry? Did you hit your head?
Why does everybody keep asking that?
Why indeed?
So can we go now, boss? Without getting handcuffed?
Don't give me ideas, Santino.
Thanks, boss.
Okay, we have... Oh, hi! So we have a lot to read. Blue? What? No. Blue about what? And what about Molly? Natasha saved our lives at the last minute. Once Albert had revealed everything, so there we go, that's it. But is it really over? No, what about Molly? What a surprise! In the end, she was the one who pulled the trigger and saved us. But of course, if it wasn't for her, we wouldn't have been in this situation in the first place. The old man's small, hairy heart softened in the end, huh? And all it took was the downfall of a gangster empire, nothing more. Yeah, you're welcome! Monica? Monica knew what we are up to and informed the boys just in time. If not for her, Wrestler's goons would have most likely riddled us with bullets. I mean, the two of them that we already outmatched twice? Surely. Albert honestly believes he and Ethan Wrestler are one and the same, two souls in one body. I don't even know what to think about this madness, but one thing is without question, Albert is a vicious beast and he has to go down, no matter what. Albert could have done anything to prevent his secret from emerging, but it was too late. Natasha felt something wasn't right with him, and Albert knew he couldn't get away with it. It's simple. Deadly simple. How many of you guys? Timothy?
Look what garbage the wind brought in.
Good God, is this guy everywhere?
Our faithful chronicler.
I swear I'm gonna hang him someday. How the hell did you find your way here, Tim? Always where the trouble is.
Sometimes I think you're the criminal mastermind behind all the dark dealings in this city.
I wish.
I wish too. Because then we could legally throw you in jail.
I love your sense of humor, Sonny.
I wasn't joking.
So, where did you get the scoop?
Are you kidding me? The whole city's talking about you. You've left quite the mess behind.
That I admit.
Well, it's a miracle that all of the city smear sheet journalists aren't here already. Oh, while we're at it, will you give me an exclusive interview?
At Zips? Sure.
Fuck off, Tim.
Aww.
Hey. Just one quote, guys. They say you've taken down the whole Wrestler Empire. They say...
I say you're full of shit, Tim. And you can quote me on that.
Just one quote, guys.
Okay. Oh, hi! Hi!
What about him? How the hell did he wind up here?
I don't know, but it's suspicious.
You think someone hired him?
We know that Natasha hired him as well.
Could be.
What up?
You. What are you doing here?
I was just driving around. You know.
Yeah, I know.
Trying to feed your grandpa? So? Was it a case? Were you, maybe investigating us?
What can I say, Sonny? Am I busted?
Did someone hire you to follow us?
I just had to keep an eye on you and not get involved. That's all. I admit there were a couple of crazy situations when it was hard not to.
But you managed somehow, right?
A professional's a professional, my friend.
Yeah, thanks. So you won't tell us who hired you, whatever we do?
Unfortunately, I can't, my friend. I made a promise.
You and your promises.
Some people still take him seriously.
You're a real piece of guano. You know that?
Why?
Of course. I've learned everything from you, you old fart.
Anything else?
I think I have an idea who hired you, Phil.
Hey, stop it right there. I don't want to know who you think.
Oh, are you afraid your reaction would give you away?
You wish, pal.
Can we talk about
anyway, it's good to see you here, Hawkeye.
I'm glad you made it out alive. It didn't take you much.
Yeah, not much.
Anyway, it's good to see.
Okay. What
must be
second?
Some famous historical figure. How are you with history?
Not so good.
You know, I've always been fascinated by the Founding War, especially the last great battle between the Alliance and the Swamp Clans.
Don't believe the tales they tell about the war, Marty. There's nothing glorious or beautiful in it. Just endless suffering and misery.
And a lot of money, of course.
That too.
Okay, bye! Woo! Natasha?
What will happen to her now?
I don't know, Marty. I have no idea. So, what now? Where to next?
I think I should mourn, right?
Yeah.
You should.
But I don't know what to feel anymore, Sonny.
I understand, Natasha. You know, if you need anything...
Yes, I know where to find you.
See you around, sweetheart.
Ma'am?
Goodbye, detectives.
Oh, bye-bye. Okay, we go to the entrance. Oh, hi! What the what? Hi!
Do you think she was part of it?
I don't think so, Marty. She seemed entirely honest. Maybe she was the only one who was honest with us the whole time.
You may be right.
You called the cop?
Hey, Olivia.
Marty?
I just, wanted to thank you.
For what exactly?
For trying to save us.
I didn't do it only for you, believe me. I loved my job while I had it. Now my employee is dead, so I don't have a job anymore.
I didn't even think of that.
Of course you didn't.
Can I do anything to help?
I think I'll manage. I always do.
Sorry.
If there's anything at all...
Thank you, Martin. There's no need for that.
Oh, sorry.
Please tell me there's gonna be a glorious shootout.
If we're lucky, Marty. If we're lucky.
Hi, guys. What up?
Gentlemen.
Gentlemen?
We're honestly very sorry it had to end like this.
Yeah, this peacefully.
For myself, I'm glad, gentlemen. I would have sincerely regretted it if we had to shoot both of you, but unfortunately, that seemed to be the only solution to this, rather nasty situation. Fortunately, it didn't turn out that way. Joyful.
Joyful? Thank you, thank you.
Don't think we'll be behind bars for long, chickens. Whistler may be dead, but his empire still won't crumble.
Oh, look at that, he can talk.
In complex sentences, too.
Oh, don't be like that, I like him.
Yeah, or something like that.
Amazing.
Let's go.
Look at that, the mongrel caught himself some big game.
Now he can wag his tail.
Yuck.
Hi.
You're a good boy, Bosco. Nice work.
Oh, nice work? What is nice work? That he's here?
You know, folks, somebody's gotta take care of the real police work while you're tearing up the city.
Well, yeah, that's true.
Sorry for the mess, Bosco, but you know us.
Yeah, unfortunately, I do.
How did you catch them? After the gunshot, I was sure these two would show up. They have a habit of doing that.
They were already in cuffs before then, Sonny. We had the house surrounded. If you could have hung on, maybe nobody would have died.
Oh, what? It wasn't our fault.
Hey, a second longer and it would have been us.
That's your story.
Cluck you sideways, Bosco. Nice catch, Bosco. You can mount them on your wall as trophies.
Yeah, I wish I could, Sonny.
Okay, bye. Monica?
I don't know if I've ever seen Monica in daylight.
This means she's real, not just the ghost of the police station.
So, you can finally ask her out on a date.
I didn't even hear that.
Now we want cat lady, right?
Thanks again, Mon. If not for you, those fur heads would have put holes in us.
No wonder, since you put holes in their boss.
Well, actually, that wasn't us.
Then who was it?
Natasha.
Really? I wouldn't have thought it of her. It's a pleasant surprise.
It was for us too, believe me. How did you know we were here?
I always pay attention, Sonny. And because I know you like you are my own nestlings.
Yeah, you said it before.
No, I love it when you say pretty little things like that.
Don't get used to it, Marty.
chingar.
So, what's your shoe size again, Mon?
45.
35, Sonny. I like high heels. And because there's two of you, two pairs will do for a start.
Yeah, and black ones.
Anything for you, darling.
I don't want just anything, Marty. I want shoes.
Black high heels, I know.
Yes, ma'am.
See you at the PD?
At the PD, Mon.
Okay.
Damn, I wouldn't have thought it, but I'm glad the old hound's here.
What? Are you waiting for me to change my mind?
I don't know.
No, sir.
Then stop pecking around here.
Bowie.
Yes, sir. So, here they are, ladies and gentlemen. The Chicken Police in the flesh.
Hi. Wave to your mother. We are on the television. Hi.
Damn it, Tim. Drop it and cluck off.
Oh, no, boys. This time, you deserve it.
Wait, are you telling we haven't deserved it all the previous times?
What the cluck did you say, boss?
Stand up straight and try to look like someone who's glad to be alive.
Yes, sir, we'll try.
Ooh, attention Chicken Police, say cheese.
Okay. Wow. I mean, I liked it overall. I think it was nice. Aww. Look at all the Hungarian developers. I'm so proud, even if I have nothing to do with it. But still, yeah, I enjoyed it. Oh, we are listening to this song again because we haven't listened it for already two times. Yeah. So, I enjoyed it overall. I think I would have liked if there would be a bit more action in it and a bit more variety of that. Because we only had, you know, the sequence on the boat when we were set on fire. And oh, is that Olivia, you think? In the pretty black dress? That looks like an Olivia model for me. So yeah, we only had the fire on the ship and two shooting sequences, like in with a car chase thingy. And I would have liked a bit more, I think. Especially because at the shooting range, we were learned how to shoot at persons and not to shoot civilians. So I would expect it like a chase scene on foot, like in a crowd, where you would actually have to shoot the bad guys without, you know, accidentally shooting the civilians. And if you did shoot someone accidentally, then you could like get into jail for that, and that would be an additional bad ending. So yeah, it's pretty linear, which is fine, but it could have had little dead ends like that. Maybe it had, and I just didn't found them. But overall, I liked it very much. Oh, and that is Natasha. Oh. Yeah, I enjoyed it way more than I thought I would. It was very slow paced at the beginning, but as it is a noir detective visual novel, I don't even know what I was expecting. But yeah. I'm glad we played it. I know it ended up being a very long video. I thought I'm gonna be able to wrap it up quicker, but it is what it is. And I know you are going to continue this. Oh, hi.
Natasha.
You were expecting me, weren't you?
I wouldn't say that, but I'm not surprised.
I just wanted to talk to you.
About what exactly?
You know very well.
What do you think, Natasha? Why didn't she tell me?
Because she loved you.
Yeah.
If it wasn't for you, she may have never left the place. Perhaps she'd still be there.
Ah, sheep shit.
We used to dream about falling in love with a nice man who comes and saves us someday. A knight in shining armor. You know, like in the fairy tales.
And how did that work out for you?
She fell in love with a good guy. I didn't. I envy her.
I'm not that good guy, Natasha. But if it's any consolation, she could have found him. Maybe she's living with him right now, somewhere on the other side of the world.
Well, goodbye, Sonny.
So long, sweetheart. Hey, Natasha, you have a light? I've been trying to smoke this sorry-ass cig all day. It's driving me crazy.
Maybe you don't really need it.
Maybe you're right. Maybe.
Whatever happens, happens. Hey! I may have realized that I haven't read the collectible novel things, those short stories to you, the first time I was recording the video. So when I went back, I realized that I missed one. I missed one book and it made me so angry, I decided I will give it another try. I started a new run and therefore we are stopping here as well, because I managed to skip this room the first time we were here. So we are going to take a look at this room, get the remaining one book and then read them. That's the plan. So the first time we started with the writing desk, and that was a mistake as it turns out, because this progresses the story automatically. So we are going to look at everything else now. Fancy bed.
You know, I don't think he had it so bad in here.
You mean apart from being separated from everyone you love in an ancient mansion filled with madmen?
You're right.
As always.
Pretty! It's like the ones in the brothel.
The style. It's very familiar to me.
Yeah.
You've been lonely for far too long, huh?
Not funny, Marty.
It is, a little.
But it really looks like the paintings in the... what's the name? The Sweltering Nile.
So this is an original Albert Wessler.
Yeah?
I think so. It's pretty good, I must say. And I saw something very similar in Natasha's room.
As well, yes.
You kept me out of it.
Sorry, little boy. Maybe next time.
Yeah, but we know that...
it's hot in here.
Already.
Okay, Marty, that's enough.
Okay, I get it. We're going... anything else about the bed, though?
Well, I guess the bed has to find a new owner soon.
Are you really so sure he's not alive anymore?
I never said that. Well, I guess the bed has to find...
okay. Creepy mural.
No way! Is this some kind of puzzle?
Oh, I missed the puzzle! Oh, no! I don't want to do a puzzle.
I don't think so. But we could still find something important here. A pattern, a sign, anything.
Okay. Looking for important things. What kind of important things? Wah! You don't are you doing? Oh, these are numbers. Do I have to... Oh, I have to draw something. I think I messed up already. What do we do here? Can I undo it? What are we doing? That is Cat Lady. That's Natasha. We are counting to 8 for some unknown reason. This is the mansion, the asylum where we are in right now. This is a cop car, maybe. Oh, this is his signature. Do I have to like... That's it, no? Eyes everywhere. Oh, infinity. Oh, it's disappearing slowly. I do have to connect things, right? But what? What important thing can you possibly find here? And what is this figure, by the way? The rabbit of infinity dripping, I don't know what, from their mouth? Yeah, artistic shit, alright. What am I doing here? I have no idea. Ah, so I can draw 4 things at a time. But which 4? And what do I have to do with it? No? Why 8? What do we need a code for this? What is happening? I can see the numbers here, all right.
A small window, a small hope.
Can we look at anything else? Can you tell me something else about the painting?
It's hot in here.
Okay, no. What about the mural? I wonder. Maybe we have to, like, this is a signature for sure. This may be also a signature. Like, what are we looking for? I don't think we got any clues for this one. Is this a signature? Maybe this one. And we can draw 4 different things? Like one, two.
That design, it's like 2 letters.
Oh, that was it? But we didn't even need all 4. It's disappointing. Why can I draw 4 things when I only need 2?
Exactly. And where have we seen these 2 letters?
It was only 2 letters. I thought it was 2 different signatures.
Where?
Think, Marty. Let's take a look in our bag.
That piece of painting. Of course. So it's a signature. A.W., that's...
Albert Wessler, the painter. This was what Natasha wanted to show us. The link between Ibn, Albert... and her.
It all started with the painting.
It would have been a way bigger revelation, a more impactful thing to discover, you know. The first time we were here, I just messed it up. I'm sorry about that. It's not it don't hit that hard anymore.
Yeah, and it'll end when we find the painting.
With Ibn Wessler.
When? He's right, because the painting is in Ibn's room, so yeah.
Maybe, but I have another theory too.
Okay, then we looked at everything. that we could? Yes, I think yes. So, I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna get the last book and then meet you there when we are rereading them. Hey! So, just so you know, the one novel that I missed is here. Right here. The Color Killers. Yes, so now we can go and read them all. I checked out the Chandler's. I don't know, the bookstore front the last time as well, but I didn't found the book itself. So now we can go and yes, we have all three of the remaining books. So let's get into it. The Color Killers. The Chicken Police find themselves outside Clovial's borders on the exotic Torugu Plateau, working on a case centered around the disappearance of an old comrade. They find their friend dead in the depths of the jungle, along with the descendants of an ancient cult whose members live like animals did several millennia ago, according to nature's bygone rules. I mean, using the term live like animals in this game specifically, it's a bit strange, but yes, okay. For a handful of waffles, a rookie arrives in the city, an ambitious and fierce cat detective to become. As long as Marty is on vacation, Sonny's substitute partner. Their first case together is, right off the bat, a double murder where, oddly enough, the new detective is involved personally. Could it be a coincidence? And how does the new waffle factory, whose products have flooded the city, come into the picture? Waffles flooded the city? And I wasn't there? All will be revealed in the latest Chicken Police story, guest starring Inspector Waffles. Your name is Waffles. You're such a cutie. And a waffle factory as well. I want waffles. Look at how cuties. And the last one. Farewell from Files. Sunny Featherlands and Marty Mexican's last case, which sees the return of their mysterious stalker, the gentleman in the cylinder. Sunny's life is in grave danger. Someone kicks the bucket for good. The Chicken Police disband, and blood-soaked riots push the city to the brink of utter chaos. As fast-paced, shocking, and ruthless end to the series, Chicken Police War 10. Wow, wowzies. Look at her, pretty. Now, I read that if you collect all the novels, then you can get a secret ending. So I'm gonna go check out if that's true or I missed something that I should have got. And if there is a secret ending, I'm going to show that to you. Is this the secret ending? Oh, is it? This is the secret ending, okay. Because we got the previous one already. Don't dare to knock. Oh, and this is Olivia. That's it? That's all we got? Okay. Well, that was a very neat foreshadowing for the series. And well, let's just get back to the ending of the original video. Oh, it was nice. It was very good. I have completely lost my train of thought, by the way. Yeah, I liked at the end, those little live action snippets here and there. That was cool. So yeah, we know it's gonna be continued with the Chicken Police into the Hive. I don't know if it's gonna have any connection with this story, but I hope it is gonna get connected somehow. I like the twist at the end in the story. I appreciated it. It was good. But the very end with the interrogation and Natasha shooting him at the end, it felt a bit, I don't even know, flat. It was just, I expected something more, something more exciting. It was really just flat. But yeah, overall it was a great experience. I hope you enjoyed it. And thank you all if you managed to watch this far. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to let YouTube know about it by liking and subscribing. Leave a comment, tell me what you thought about the series, tell me what you would like to see on the channel. And no one likes outros, so bye bye!